Hi everyone, today we're going to talk to you about Palaeolithic portable art and a new programme of work where we've integrated experimental and digital techniques to better understand this phenomenon. So the area that we're focusing on is plaquettes, and this is a particularly common type of portable art that we see in the Magdalenian period towards the end of the Palaeolithic period. They're known for being made from quite soft stones, such as limestone or sandstone, but limestone in particular, and they're commonly known for their naturalistic animal engravings, but they can be very densely and complexly engraved as well. Beyond this, and perhaps less well studied than the engravings themselves, there's a whole range of other processes that we see with this type of art. That can include painted surfaces, typically with red ochre and charcoal, giving you red and black paint respectively. Also traces of heating or burning, and debates continue about whether this is intentional or not, depending on the objects in question. Fragmentation may also fit in this category of possible intentional traces in the later stages of the life of these objects. And in some examples, their surfaces have been refreshed and they've been engraved anew. So we can see they're a very complex type of art. And we're particularly interested in this phase of work in the relationship between these objects and heat, which Izzy will talk us through in a bit more detail now.
Yeah, so to draw out some of the complexity related to the uses of plaquettes, we designed a number of different experiments to kind of explore how plaquettes might have been used in relation to heating activities. So the first of this was to determine whether the heating signatures we see on some plaquettes might have just been due to kind of incidental taphonomic action. So we partially buried some plaquettes exposed on the surface at different distances away from a hearth and recorded the heating signatures we saw on those plaquettes. We also wanted to explore the functionality of some of these plaquettes and whether they might have been used as boiling stones. So we heated a number of plaquettes and placed them in water to determine whether that made an appreciable difference to the water temperature. And within this experiment, we observed that there was quite a dynamic and performative aspect that happened when water comes into contact with a hot plaquette. So we further explored this by taking some heated plaquettes and pouring water over the top and recording the visual phenomena that occurs with this. And we also placed plaquettes in this kind of open oven structure and again recorded the heating signatures we saw on those. And we compared these heating signatures we saw on this variety of different heating activities with the collection from Montastruc. So Andy had recorded plaquettes from Montastruc using macro photography and 3D modelling. And we used additional digital methods such as de-stretch to better visualise the heating signatures on these plaquettes and VR modelling to integrate the observations we have made in the experiments with those observations Andy had made on the plaquettes from Montastruc. And what we found was plaquettes that were placed in a configuration where they were close to the hearth were really brought to life by this use of a dynamic roving light source. And these plaquettes from our experiments had the most similar heating signatures to the plaquettes from Monstruck. So we explored this more visually through using VR modelling, which you can see on the left, to further demonstrate how the engraved forms on the plaquettes are brought to life under a flickering roving light source.
So we feel that the results that we've generated so far provide some really important insights into the later phases of the life of Magdalenian plaquettes, their potential positioning around small hearth structures, their potential direct contact, leaving these distinct discolorations on the limestone, suggestive of temperatures above 250 degrees, that we might see some insights here into how these objects were understood and used, that we may need to think more dynamically in terms of the context of use and perhaps of production, low light levels, moving light sources, the bringing to life of naturalistically engraved animal depictions. More widely, we feel the experimental results that we've generated may allow us to explore related areas such as fire modified and fire cracked rock which we see in abundance on a number of Magdalenian sites and may provide further insights into fire technologies during this period. Thanks so much for your attention, and we'd love to take any questions that you might have.